Hello friends, welcome to a new episode of Drishti IAS Editorial Analysis. In this editorial analysis, we do three things. First of all, we link the editorial to the UPSC syllabus. Secondly, we try to understand the key points of the editorial. And thirdly, if any key concepts have come in the editorial and are important from exam point of view, we also discuss that. So let us begin today's editorial analysis.
Dear viewer, this video is available in Hindi as well. If you wish to watch it, please visit our Hindi YouTube channel, Drishti IAS. For your convenience, the link for this video in Hindi has been provided in the description below.
We have taken today's editorial from Times of India and it has appeared on 3rd of July. The title of the editorial is Indian Paradox and it says that educating girl child solves India's population problem, but male preference continues deadly run. So let us look at its linkage with the syllabus. We find that it links directly with GS Paper 1 and also with GS Paper 2. In GS Paper 1, it relates to role of women and women's organization, population and associated issues. Whereas in GS Paper 2, it relates to issues relating to development and management of social sector services relating to health, education and human resources. So after establishing the linkage with the syllabus, now let us look at its key points. Before moving on to the key points of the editorial, let us look at this infographic. So this infographic is based on the Sample Registration System Statistical Report 2018, which has recently come out. And it says that 13 states of India are showing a decline in population levels. And this decline is measured in terms of fertility level. So here we should be clear about what is fertility level and what is meant by replacement fertility level. So if we say that 2.1 live births per women is the replacement fertility level at the global level, then this means that 2.1 births for every woman replaces the parents' generation with the new generation. Exactly. But here we should also note that for countries with higher infant mortality rate like India, the replacement fertility rate is slightly higher than the global standards. So the Indian average is 2.2. And this has come down from the very high rate of 5.9 in 1950s, which was 5.2 in 1971 and has reached 2.2 in 2018. And the steady decline has been seen since 1975. Another important fact to consider here is that now 13 states in India have below replacement fertility level. And Gujarat is the only state which is having exact replacement fertility level. And 8 states are having above replacement fertility level rate. And if we consider rural India and urban India, then rural India has a higher fertility rate of 2.4, while urban India has a total fertility rate of 1.7. This report also clearly shows that it is not just the age, which is a very important factor when we consider the reproductive capacity of women, but education levels of women also have a significant impact on fertility levels. And this report says that at the national level, the total fertility rate for illiterate women in 2018 was 3, while for literate women, it was only 2.1. And it says that the gradual total fertility rate decline increases with the level of education. And here we should know what is total fertility rate. So it indicates the average number of children expected to be born to a woman during her entire reproductive period. And this can be further understood by this example that a rural woman with a total fertility rate of 2.4 will have about one child more than an urban woman having a total fertility rate of 1.7. So with this basic background, now let us look at the key points of the editorial. So the editorial says that educating girl child can solve India's population problem is very evident in the sample registration system statistical report data. So the editorial also points out that 13 out of 22 states for which data is available have fallen below replacement fertility levels. But this also creates a challenge for India that India will now need to start preparing for a phase of population decline. And it says that the Hindi heartland states, especially Bihar, Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh along with Assam are above replacement fertility levels of 2.1. This we should be knowing that the replacement fertility level globally is 2.1. and these states are having TFRs ranging between 2.4 and 3.2. But other than these states, which are outliers, all the other states are showing a preference for 1 and 2 child families, which is very evident through this data. Editorial also says that those states which are now experiencing a decline in the fertility levels, they need to prepare for this population drop. And in these states, it will be very important that the jobs for locals sentiment has to be toned down, and it should give way to policies which welcome migration. Otherwise, these states are going to face labor shortages, uncompetitive wages, and economic stagnation. Also, in these states, with the proportion of elderly persons rising, they must plot capacity expansion in healthcare and social security schemes. Also, the editorial points towards the benefits of educating girl child. It says the SRS data also indicates a strong correlation between education levels of women and declining fertility rates. And it says that the average total fertility rate was 1.7 among graduate women, 1.8 and 1.9 respectively for those educated up to class 12 and 10, and 2.5 for those with primary education, and 3.0 among illiterate women. Now, this is a very good statistic for writing in your mains answers or in essay writing, because it shows how with increasing levels of education, the total fertility rate is declining among women. So this is a very strong argument for women education and why government should prioritize this. Also, it says that rather than coercive birth control measures, the states which are lagging behind in population control, they must focus on learning outcomes and keeping girls in school, as that would help in controlling the population. But the editorial also points to the downside to the smaller families, which could lead to greater sex selection practices, putting the girl child at an existential disadvantage. And this is very evident in India, where the sex ratio has been declining sharply. And the editorial points out that the sex ratio at birth in 2016-18 was just 899 females per 1000 males. Though this is a 3-point increase from 2014-16, but it is nevertheless a fall from 906 in 2012-14. Also, the UN Population Fund's State of World Population Report 2020 calculates that 4.6 lakh girl children annually went missing in India due to sex selection during this period. And this is a blot on India, which India must try to erase fast. Though the government has taken some steps like Beti Bachao Beti Padhao campaign, but still it remains a societal problem, and the government can only facilitate the process, but the change has to come from the society, where still male child is preferred over the female child, and that needs to change. So this was all in the key points of the editorial. Now let us look at the key concepts. So in key concepts, let us look at total fertility rate. Now, total fertility rate is the number of children expected to be born per woman during her entire span of reproductive period, which ranges from 15 to 49 years. And India's total fertility rate is declining. It is now 2.2 per woman and nearing the replacement rate of 2.1. And here we should know what is replacement rate as well. So the replacement level is the number of children needed to replace the parents' generation, after accounting for fatalities, skewed sex ratio, infant mortality, etc. And population starts falling below this level. And another important thing to note here is that the total fertility rate has more than halved in both urban and rural areas in India, and falling even below the replacement level in the urban areas. Now let us look at the sample registration system survey. So this sample registration system survey was initiated by the government of India in the late 1960s to provide reliable estimates of birth and death rates for all the states, and also at all India level under the Office of Registrar General. So it provides annual data on fertility and mortality at the state and national levels for rural and urban areas. And the SRS in India is based on a dual record system. The field investigation under SRS consists of a continuous enumeration of births and deaths in a sample of villages, urban blocks by a resident part-time enumerator, and an independent 6-monthly retrospective survey by a full-time supervisor. The data obtained through these two sources are matched. The unmatched and partially matched events are re-verified in the field to get an unduplicated count of correct events. So it is done very meticulously. Now let us look at the 2018 survey data for some important areas. So in 2018 survey data, birth rate, which is measured as the total number of live births per 1000 in a population in a year or a particular period. So these definitions should be remembered. So crude birth rate was in totality 20, and in rural area it is more, 21.6, whereas in urban area it is only 16.7. Death rate is the total number of deaths per 1000 in a population in a year or a particular period, and if we look at that, here too it was higher in rural area than in urban area. Then we come to sex ratio, which is number of females per 1000 males, and it was in total 899, while for rural area it was higher at 900 and for urban area it was 897. If we look at fertility rate, the total fertility rate is the number of children expected to be born per woman during her entire span of reproductive period of 15 to 49 years. So it was 2.2 overall and 2.4 in rural and 1.7 in urban area. And if we look at infant mortality rate, which is defined as the number of deaths per 1000 live births of children under 1 year of age, so it was in totality 32, while it was higher in rural India at 36 and lower in urban area at 23. So after this, now let us look at the kind of questions that can be asked in prelims and mains. So in prelims, a question can be asked on the sample registration system statistical report 2018, and some database question can be asked. So one should be knowing that. Also, a question can be asked on total fertility rate, in which state it has been the highest and in which state it has been the lowest. So highest has been in Bihar and the lowest has been in Delhi and West Bengal. Again, questions can be asked on replacement fertility level. So this we know is 2.1. Then questions can be on Beti Bachao Beti Padhao campaign. So one should be clear why it has been launched and some stats related to this as well. Then a very important concept has been given by the Economic Survey of 2017-18, which is son mate up preference. So it says that in a family, more number of girls are born till the family gets the son, and this shows some skewed family sizes. So this is about son mate up preference. While in mains, question can be asked about education for girl child and its role in population stabilization. Also, a question can be asked about the declining sex ratio in India. What are the factors contributing to it and what measures have been taken and what more steps need to be taken for correcting the sex ratio in India. So this was all in today's editorial analysis. We'll see you next time with another editorial. Thank you.